Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to Fortron Academy. My name is Harshwats, and in today's video, I am giving an introduction on OneDrive. So this video is completely about introduction of OneDrive. So what we will discuss in today's video, the point of discussion in today's video is what is OneDrive. After that, in the second point, we will cover why do we use OneDrive. Thirdly, we will tell you how to use OneDrive, and in the end we will cover tips and tricks for using the OneDrive. So this video covers a detailed perspective of OneDrive and detailed analysis of a OneDrive. So with this thing, the question may arise in your mind, what is OneDrive? So OneDrive is actually previously known as SkyDrive, which is introduced by Microsoft in 2007. So what is it? So Microsoft OneDrive is a file hosting service and a synchronization service operated by Microsoft as part of its web version of Office. First launched in August 2007, OneDrive allows users to store files and personal data like Windows settings or BitLocker recovery keys in the cloud, share files and sync files across Android, Windows and iOS mobile device, Windows and Mac OS computers, and the Xbox 360 and Xbox One consoles. Users can upload Microsoft Office documents to OneDrive. So I hope you got a glimpse of what I'm talking about. So if I want to say in a few words what OneDrive is, I will say it is a space which is not physical, but it is something that you upload on your cloud and it is saved on certain server, and you can access your server through internet anytime from anywhere. You just need a username and password. For example, let me tell you, when you save something on your computer or your laptop or your mobile, it is stored in certain physical space within that device that may be called in certain like laptop and computer as hard disk, or in mobile you can call them SD cards. So you can see that thing is actually within your device. There's nothing going on. If something happens to your device, if your hard disk got corrupted, if your SD card got corrupted, all the data will be wiped out. But it is not the same case with OneDrive. OneDrive is a cloud service. So how the actually cloud service works, like there are certain server in the world in a different geographical locations. So when you upload something on the cloud, it is saved on those server, and those server are highly secured. No one in the entire world can control or access your data until or unless there are huge blackout or there's something that happened on those server. If something happened on those server, the data will be transferred to the other server. So that is how your data will be stored completely safe on OneDrive. That is a cloud storage, and that also helps you to clean up your physical space. You do not require a lot of hard disk space when you can use a cloud storage. So everything in your hard disk can be uploaded into OneDrive, and it will be available for you for throughout the life. It doesn't matter which computer you use. You can access it on computer, laptop, iOS, Android. It doesn't matter which device it requires. It will access it. So now, why do we use OneDrive? This is the main question most of the people ask. Because like the certain people says, it is better that you store everything in a hard disk, or you can buy a portable hard disk. But what if you didn't remember to take it? But what if you forget it? But what if it being taken by someone else? If it is have a like a permanent damage, you cannot restore it. So those are the things that always happen with a physical space, but it won't happen with a OneDrive, because with a OneDrive sharing is easy. That means when you upload something on a OneDrive and if you want to share it with someone, you can easily do that. Or if there is no more accidental deletes. Like if I delete something from my OneDrive, it going to recycle bin. You can access it from the recycle bin as well. So there is no more accidental deletes. Like if I delete some file from my computer, which is accidental and it corrupts my whole window, it won't happen with a OneDrive. Tons of data storage. So you see, in a physical space, we have a limited data storage capacity. That means, like in my computer, if it has 500 GB of HDD, then I can only store 500 GB of data. But if I use a OneDrive with a paid service, then I can go extend it to 6 TB. That is more than sufficient for anything else. So there's also option that we can use versioning. What is versioning? Like if I work on a certain Microsoft Office Word file, if I did something on that, after that I share it to someone else, then that person worked on it, and other than it goes from there to upward in a chain, after that it comes back. Or I worked on certain work, like I worked today, after that tomorrow, after that tough 10 days after, then it create a versioning. So you have a version of every work. So you don't have to think like 10 days before what I have done. You can go there and see it. There is another option, work from home. As in COVID, we are in particular situation that we cannot have access of a lot of physical space. So then work from home is the most crucial thing you can use OneDrive for. You do not have to think about where I should store everything. Like for me, if I want to store all these YouTube videos in my laptop, it won't happen. Like it won't work. Like for in 1 month only, my whole physical space will be occupied. But on OneDrive, when I upload everything, I can see my files are there. It is completely safe. I can access it, and it is not occupying physical space on my physical hard disk. So that's the use of a OneDrive. There is also automatic saving features in OneDrive. Like in my earlier videos, when you see, I used Microsoft Whiteboard or OneNote, all those things, Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, if you allow it with auto on and saving it on the OneDrive, you don't have to save everything. You just have to work on it. After that, you leave it or you close that file. OneDrive will do that work for you. Do not have to think about what happened if light goes out, if I haven't saved anything. Everything will be saved. And the most crucial is about collaboration. If you want to work more than one person, then you can collaborate in a using a OneDrive. That other person which has a large, like I have a large Power BI file, and I want to collaborate with 10 to 15 people, then OneDrive is where you can store it and you can ask the person to come and work on that file there only. So this is one thing. And emailing is faster than ever. So for OneDrive, if you attach something from a OneDrive, that you don't have to think about like this is so much of data, how will I do that? So it will just send a link and that person will click on the link and could access the OneDrive from there. You do not have to think. And the most important is on the go. Like if you are working on your laptop, I worked certain thing on my laptop, but I forget and I have an important meeting on my office, in my office, then what should I do? I am completely screwed, right? But not if you are using OneDrive. You can access it through your mobile, or you can access it using the username and password from someone else's computer, and you can play the PowerPoint from there. Now it is also integrated through 365 services. So this is one of the most crucial. So it is also integrated with Office 365 services. So this is one of the most crucial thing in which you can use the OneDrive for. So it is integrated with Office 365 service, Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Whiteboard, Kaizala, all these things, Planner, and everything you can work in OneDrive. Now let's move forward and let me tell you how to use OneDrive and how do you access OneDrive. Now we are in Internet Explorer. So this is a Microsoft 365. So this is what OneDrive is. OneDrive save your files and photos to OneDrive and access them from any device anywhere. So you can see the plan and pricing. When I click in here, you will see Microsoft. So India it is. So you can see Microsoft in an Indian currency. This is much better. Best for 6 people, it's 5299 rupees per year. In this you get 6 TB storage service including OneDrive and Microsoft 365. You can also go for the different thing, and if you want to use it for free, 5 GB of OneDrive basic is free. You can use it. So now we will sign in. So I will sign in and will tell you how do you operate OneDrive. I am already a member of Microsoft 365 paid version, so I have all the facility available. So now I signed in, so it will take me to the Microsoft OneDrive, and this is what OneDrive look like from inside. Right, so this is my files, recent, shared, recycle bin and flag. So flag is a shared library. I have shared and work on it with my colleagues. So this is my personal file. You can see I have these files in my OneDrive. You can see this is a PPT. If I click on it, you will see it will take me to the online PowerPoint, and I can make changes in here as well. So this is the slide for this video only, which is currently I'm working on, still saved on the Microsoft OneDrive. So you can see I can access anything from here as well. I will close it for now. Now you can see this file in your OneDrive. What you can do with it? So you can share this file by clicking in here, share the selected file. I will click in here. You will see you can share it with send link. People in Fortron Incorporation with the link can view. You can click here and you can allow anyone with a link, people in Fortran, people with existing access, specific people, or allow editing. You can do all these things. You can also block the download, that other person could not download that. So you can always do all these things with your OneDrive. Let me cancel it and will show you all more things. If I click in here, these are the 3 points that I have option for. One, open in browser, open in app. That means this is a PowerPoint file. If I click on open in browser, it will open in browser that I've shown you. Just let me click it again. Now you will see it is just opened in browser. If I click on, it will open on the application that is installed in my computer. Now let me close it again. Now we will talk about more feature. I will click it preview. So it will give you a preview. In here, when you click on it, you will see something like this. It will give you a preview, and I do not want to wait for long, so I will close it for now. So now you can see this is the preview. So this is also the feature of Microsoft OneDrive. You can preview anything, PDF, Excel, it doesn't matter, video, everything you can preview. After that, share. I have already talked about share. You can click from here or here as well. You can copy the link. You can copy the link and share it with anyone else, and that person could access your documents. Or you can manage the access. When I click on manage access, you can see link giving access. It has not shared. I have the direct access to. But if I add someone, you can grant the access to another person. It doesn't matter the person has a link. They cannot access it until or unless you grant them access, which you do it from here. After that, when I again go back and again see the features, manage access, I have already told you, download. So this is on the cloud. It is not saved on my computer or laptop. So if I want it to download on my laptop, just I click on download, or you can access it online as well. You do not have to download it. It will save again on my OneDrive. Other than you can delete, or you can move to. You can move to particular more so more folder or something like that. You can copy to. You can also copy to. If I click on, you can copy to your OneDrive or for that particular, like this is my flag, which is where I collaborate with certain person. If I want to save it on that, you can do that, or you can click on if there is new folder, you can do that as well. So if I again click in here, you can rename it, you can automate it, where you can use a Power Automate function. Copy file as PDF in OneDrive, request sign off, Power Automate, Power Automate. You can create a flow or see your flow. You can do that. Now, I have told you about version. If I click in here, you will see every day it is getting modified. 19 minutes ago, it was modified. 25 minutes yesterday at 10:07 p.m. it was modified. 5:24, it was modified. If I want to access it, I can just restore it and will access that particular version. So it saved all the version. You can see how much I have modified this particular file. In a past 5 to 6 days, I have modified it a lot. Like this has been modified 23rd time. So this has saved only 23rd version. What are the first version you can see here, and what are the 23rd version you can see here. You just have to click and restore and open file. In here you also restore or open file. That will save, tell you the particular version. So that is the most useful and most best feature of the OneDrive. Again, I will cancel it, and again I move on to details. So when I click on details, it will specify you that it is a PPT which has 32 views till now. It has done by me only, has access by me. Activity, you edited this file 22 minutes ago. You edited this file. You can see how much I have edited this file. So this is complete. Type pptx file modified, path is this. So this is the size. This is complete option for my files on OneDrive. So these are the things, or these all things are available in here also. When I click on it, if I click on it, you will see move, download, delete, and copy to. All these are available. So if I click again in here, you will see share, copy, download, delete, rename, automate, move to. And in here you can copy and version history and everything. And if you want to sort, like if I uploaded a lot of things on my OneDrive and I want to sort them on the type, you can do that. Like this is OneNote, this is PDF, this is PPT, this is Excel. Like this has been modified on the basis, sorted on the basis of type. I can sort it on the basis of name, modified by size, ascending, descending. You can do that. In spite of that, you can also make a list, compact list. You can also do. You can make a tiles as well. So this is the best feature which you can use in a OneDrive. After that, we have a recent. Like all the recent files are available in OneDrive. So what you have recently accessed will be available here. In spite of that, you have another feature that is shared. Like you can see, these are the recent file which I've used. You can see last access 5 minutes ago. So in spite of that, we have the fourth feature, which is a shared. When I click on shared, you will see shared with you or shared by you. I haven't shared anything, so you won't be able to see any file which I've shared. So these are the things you can share to. After that, we have a recycle bin. In recycle bin, you can see you have a two folder. If I click on my folder, so it will ask me to restore it. So can't find what you are looking, check the second stage recycle bin. So this is the benefit. So there are two stage recycle bin. Once you delete it, you can click on second stage recycle bin. The file is directed to the second stage recycle bin. From there, you can also restore that file. If I want to restore the my folder, you just have to click on restore, or you can delete it. In spite of that, these are the shared libraries which you can create on Microsoft Teams. So if I created shared libraries on a team, like in here, when I go, you will see flag. So what is, how it is different from normal thing. So when I click in here, open the detail pane. So you will see it's a flag. This is a Teams and documents. When I click in here, you will see activity. So these are the things you can see. There are a lot of other person in spite of me who are actually working on particularly things that are available on OneDrive. So this is the benefit of using a OneDrive. So let me cancel it. And now I hope you have understood what are the things that you can use the OneDrive for. In here you can also upload. like if I want to upload files folder, which you can do from here as well. So this is the shared library, this is my personal library. If I want to upload certain thing, click on files, which you can do files. If I do particular file I can upload, like I want to upload this, just click on this. After that open, you will see that file has been uploaded. Now you can see uploaded, you can see that file here only. You can see the table PDF. If you want to delete it, click in here. After that delete, it will ask you that are you sure you want to send this item to site recycle bin. Yes, I want to do that. You will see that file is deleted. In spite of that, if I want to upload folder, like for particular PDF, I want to upload the whole the recording PDF, whole the recording folder, just click in here. After that upload, you will see all the folder will be uploaded. This is the benefit of using. And if you want your drive to sync, now what is sync? Sync is synchronization. Once you allow your computer to work on the synchronization with OneDrive, how does it work? Now let me open my computers. So now we are in my PC, and this is what will happen when you click on my computers. In here you will see OneDrive. So when I click on OneDrive, you will see something like this. So these are the files that are actually in cloud. So you can see in the status it is cloud. That means this file is not saved in my computer. This is available on the cloud. So but this file is available in my computer. So this is what you will see in a OneDrive. And if you want to remove it from here, you can just right click in here and always keep on device, or you can go on settings. So let me explain you one by one. So what OneDrive is on your computer. So if you are using Windows 10, OneDrive is inbuilt in it. You just have to sign in on it and you will see a new folder will open up. That's give you a storage, not on physical space, but on cloud. So in my PC, when I save something on C or D drive, it is saved on my physical space. But when I save something on OneDrive, it is not on physical, but it is on cloud. Make sure that internet is working when you do that. So now what we will do. So now we will tell you one by one that how you operate that on your computer. If you are using Windows 7 or 8, you can download the OneDrive from internet and just click on Google OneDrive. There you will get a software, then you can download it. So in here, in the status bar, you will see the cloud option. When I click on it, you will see OneDrive is up to date. That I have currently uploaded this GIF. Earlier I have uploaded the 50 times saving Excel shortcuts before that modified PPT. In here you will see open folder, view online, help and setting. Let me explain you one by one. Click on open folder. When I click on open folder, you will see it will take me again to the folder where I've saved it. After that you have a view online option. So it will take me to the Internet Explorer where I have just shown you that everything. Let me click on it and you will see that it has just taken me to those files again which I have just showed you. This I have completely covered earlier. Now again I will go and you will see options, help and setting. Now these are the things that you have just uploaded from your computer. Because I have signed in from my computer, I do not have to go online every time. In here you will see open, share, view online or version history, which I have already covered. These are the options you can do. Click on open, it will ask you to open on application or on online. Share you can do, view online or version history. The thing that is left with help and setting. When I click on help and setting, open your OneDrive in folder settings, view online, pause syncing. You can also pause syncing, like it is also synchronization working every bit. Like after 5 minutes you have done something, it synchronized itself. But if you want to do it once in a 24 hours, you can just pause your syncing for 24 hours. So manage storage, you can also do that. All these things. When I click on settings, so you will see there is 1 TB of storage that I have. So when I click on settings, you will see I have an account which I've currently occupied 4.1 GB of 124 GB. That means 1 TB of storage I have. So you can do a setting as well. Start OneDrive automatically when I sign in to Windows. Automatically pause sync when the device is in battery saver mode. You can change all these things. Automatically pause when the device in a metered network. Warn me before removing the file from the cloud. Notify me when sync is auto pause. Save space and download file as you use them. Account. So this is the account. Location is syncing. Backup. You can always manage backup. You can take a network, like limit to this. You can upload rate, download rate. You can use an office, use office application to sync office files that I open. Let me choose to merge file and keep both copies. All these things you can do using the settings. These are not on the online, but on the offline. When I go again on my OneDrive, on a status bar, when you click, you will see all these options. So this is the benefit of using the OneDrive. Now, if I want to make changes in the my OneDrive, now let me right click on anything. In here, you will see extra 5 options. View online settings, always keep on device, free up space. Like, what is the free up space? When I click on it, the file will be deleted from a physical space in my computer and will be uploaded into my cloud. But it is available for me. When I click on it, it will again open it, but it is not occupying certain space on my hard disk. So this is one of the best feature you can use it. So with this point, I have covered everything in the OneDrive. I have told you how to upload it, how to create certain thing, or everything I have covered, from the settings to view online to access, give access to making a new and everything. So I hope it won't make you any problem much further. And if you want to automate certain process, you can always use a Power Automate from a OneDrive. So with this point, I am going to end this video, and I hope your queries have been cleared. And if not, kindly write us in comment section and we will surely get back to you. And if this video helped you in any way, kindly drop us a like and don't forget to subscribe our channel for amazing videos in future. Till then, have an amazing and good day.